Hello. Today we are going to make a checkered flag. Inflate two different color balloons leaving about 9 inch flat tail. We're going to twist all bubbles of the same about up to 1 inch size. Twist a chain of the first 10 bubbles. In this example I use yellow and blue balloons to make the checkered pattern. Of course for the racing cars you may want to use black and white colors. Also, as you may remember, in one of the previously published instructions, we already made a smaller size checkered flag using different technique. You can find the link to the instruction at fewdoit.com. Now let's lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 bubbles in one lock twist. Take the second balloon, in my example it is a blue balloon, twist the first blue bubble, lock the free end of the first blue bubble between the 5th and the 6th yellow bubbles. And remember, you still have to hold the first yellow bubble, otherwise it may untwist. Now we twist the second and the third blue bubbles. In this example, I'm going to twist each balloon to make 12 bubbles. Lock the free end of the third blue bubble between the 3rd and 4th yellow bubbles. In this example we are making a rectangular shape piece of fabric with sides 4x6 bubbles. So we have to twist total of 24 bubbles. Now twist the 4th and 5th blue bubbles. Lock the free end of the 5th blue bubble between the 1st and the 2nd yellow bubbles. We have made the long side of the rectangle. Now let's twist the next 2 blue bubbles. Twist the 11th yellow bubble, lock free end of the 7th blue bubble with the free end of the 11th yellow bubble. Twist the next 2 blue bubbles, lock the free end of the 9th blue bubble between the 9th and 10th yellow bubbles. As you already can see, in this checkered color pattern I use 4 bubbles of the same color to represent one square. Twist the 10th blue bubble, lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 blue bubbles in one lock twist. So once again, in this example we're making just 2 squares, each square represented by 4 bubbles of the same color connected at the center of the square. Twist the 11th blue bubble, lock the free end of the 11th blue bubble between the 7th and the 8th yellow bubbles. Twist the 12th yellow bubble, cut off the rest of the yellow balloon nicely, you can use scissors, tie off the end. Twist the 12th blue bubble, cut off the rest of the blue balloon, tie off the end. Congratulations, we have made the checkered flag, rectangular shape, 4x6 bubbles. Basically, in this example, we use the same fabric as we did previously to make many different flags. We just worked in different color pattern. I mentioned it many times before, and I hope to say it many more times. I like to use the least possible number of balloons to make any sculpture. In this example we can use 4 balloons instead of 2 to make exactly the same sculpture. But guess what? We can use 2 balloons to make bigger size sculpture. Once again, let's inflate 2 balloons leaving about 8 inch flat tail. Twist a chain of the first 9 blue bubbles. In this example we're going to make a rectangular shaped piece of fabric with sides 10x4 bubbles. It takes total of 40 bubbles, so we're going to use each balloon to twist 20 bubbles. And we work in the same checkered color pattern. 4 bubbles of the same color represents one square. Twist the first yellow bubble, lock the free end of the 9th blue bubble with the free end of the first yellow bubble. You have to hold the first blue bubble to prevent bubbles from untwisting. Twist the next 2 yellow bubbles and then we lock the free end of the 3rd yellow bubble between the 7th and the 8th blue bubbles. Remember, to make the checkered color pattern, we have to alternate the colors. In each row, it goes 2 blue, 2 yellow, 2 blue, 2 yellow. Ok, twist the next 2 yellow bubbles. Lock the free end of the 5th yellow bubble between the 5th and the 6th blue bubbles. Twist the next 2 yellow bubbles. Lock the free end of the 7th yellow bubble between the 3rd and the 4th blue bubbles. Twist the next 2 yellow bubbles. Lock the free end of the 9th yellow bubble between the 1st and the 2nd blue bubbles. We have made the long side of the rectangle. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions, alternate the colors. And now I twist the chain of the next 5 yellow bubbles. And then we're going to lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 yellow bubbles in one lock twist. This is a hard part. We have to force the end of yellow balloon through the loop of 4 bubbles. It may help if you hold the connection between the 6 and 7 yellow bubbles to prevent untwisting those bubbles. And now we work the blue balloon in exactly the same fashion as we worked the yellow balloon. Twist a chain of the next 5 blue bubbles. And then we lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 blue bubbles in one lock twist. In this example, we are going to make 4 squares inside of the rectangular piece. As you remember, in the first example, we made 2 squares inside of the rectangle. Okay, let's twist the 15th blue and the 15th yellow bubbles. Lock free end of the 15th yellow and free end of the 15th blue bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the next 2 blue bubbles. And then we lock the free end of the 17th blue bubble between the 13th and 14th yellow bubbles. Work the yellow balloon in the same fashion. Twist the next 2 yellow bubbles. Lock the free end of the 17th yellow bubble between the 13th and the 14th blue bubbles. Make sure you alternate the colors to make the checkered color pattern. It's important, right? Officially, there is no strict rules regulating size or shape of checkered flags, which is good for us, right? We can make it any size, any shape. Let's twist the 18th blue bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 16 blue bubbles in one lock twist. Now let's twist the 18th yellow bubble. And lock both ends of the chain of the last 16 yellow bubbles in one lock twist. Or we can say lock both ends of the 16th yellow bubble between the 2nd and the 3rd yellow bubbles. Here I have to fix blue bubbles that I managed to untwist somehow. It wouldn't happen if I hold the connection between blue bubbles while I was pushing the end of the yellow balloon through the loop of blue bubbles. Okay, let's twist the 19th blue bubble. Lock the free end of the 19th blue bubble between the 11th and 12th yellow bubbles. Twist the 19th yellow bubble. Lock the free end of the 19th yellow bubble between the 11th and 12th blue bubbles. So far, so good. Now we can just twist the last yellow bubble, cut off the rest of the yellow balloon and tie off the end. Do the same thing with the blue balloon. And it would be it. We have made a checkered flag with sides 10 by 4 bubbles. Let's use another set of balloons to make even larger size sculpture. Twist the 20th yellow bubble. Tie the nozzle of the second yellow balloon with the free end of the 20th yellow bubble. Cut off the rest of the first yellow balloon. Let's work the blue balloon in the same way. Working in this fashion, we can add as many balloons to the sculpture as we need to make any size piece of fabric of any shape. In this example, I want to make maybe 2 more rows. So we are going to make a rectangular shaped piece of fabric this size 10 by 6 bubbles. Twist the chain of the next 4 yellow bubbles. We work on the long side of our sculpture. Lock the free end of the last yellow bubble between the nearest 2 yellow bubbles on the long side of the sculpture. Then we make a chain of next 4 blue bubbles and attach them between nearest 2 blue bubbles on the long side of the sculpture. Basically, we work the rest of the sculpture in the same fashion as described previously. There is no need to repeat the same thing over and over again. So let's skip this part and here's the end result. We have made rectangular piece of fabric with sides 10 by 6 bubbles. We use checkered color pattern. We can use this fabric to make many different sculptures. It could be medium or large size sculptures, furniture, hats, dress, animals, anything. Here's a small piece of fabric that we have made at the beginning of this video. Have fun and happy twisting!